Procainamide is effective in slowing the conduction in the atria, the ventricles, and the bundle of His Purkinje system. It does this by prolonging the P to R and the Q to T intervals and slows the refractory periods of the atria and ventricles as well as the refractory period of the atrioventricular node. Procainamide has been effective for the treatment of supraventricular tachycardia that returns after vagal maneuvers and adenosine were ineffective. It helps treat stable wide complex tachycardia of uncertain origin, stable monomorphic ventricular tachycardia with normal QT interval, atrial fibrillation with a rapid ventricular rate response in patients with Wolff-Parkinson-White syndrome, and recurrent ventricular fibrillation or pulseless V-Tach. There are some contraindications with the use of procainamide. It's important to be aware of any known sensitivity to procainamide or similar medications. Digitalis toxicity may complicate already existing AV conduction depression. Other contraindications would include third-degree heart block or pre-existing prolongation of the QRS complex and QT intervals. Procainamide should be avoided in patients with prolonged Q to T intervals and associated CHF. All right, so now let's talk about the adult dosage for procainamide. Remember that the use of procainamide is limited in ACLS for cardiac arrest due to its requirements of slow infusion and its sometimes unknown effectiveness. If it is used for recurrent ventricular fibrillation and pulseless ventricular tachycardia, we're going to want to give 20 milligrams per minute IV infusion to a total dose of 17 milligrams per kilogram. For supraventricular tachycardia, atrial fibrillation, and wide complex tachycardias of uncertain origin, administer procainamide at 20 milligrams per minute via IV infusion to that total of 17 milligrams per kilogram. For maintenance, it can be administered at 1 to 4 milligrams per minute, titrated to desired effect and the patient's response. Please note, the use of procainamide should be stopped if any of the following occurs: arrhythmia suppression, onset of hypotension, QRS complex widens by greater than 50% of the pre-treatment width, or the maximum dose of 17 milligrams per kilogram is reached.